Today, I will show you how to model a multifamily building from our free DS Max Visualization 2.0 training. Forget complicated blueprints. I show you creative modular techniques like smart extrudes and dynamic modifiers to craft a visually compelling, high-impact model. The methods I use to create the building are based on the principles of modular architecture. These methods will help you to create an interesting architectural model without any architectural plans, so that you can get creative and have some fun. Let's go then. Create a box in the top view. Set the dimensions to 1200 cm length, 2400 cm width, and 300 cm height. The base module we will base our architecture on will be 300 cm. Let's create segments to create a modular grid. Apply Edit Poly Modifier and choose Polygon. You can use 4 on your keyboard as a shortcut. Next, Smart Extrude the left corner polygon. To do so, don't forget to hold Shift on your keyboard. This way, we'll delete this one module. Do the same on the other side of this building floor. One more Smart Extrude at the front to create a balcony, but this time Smart Extrude the polygon by 150 cm. Snap it to the middle of the neighboring module. Next, we'll create the window and door openings. Let's start with the corner one as it will be created slightly differently. Select the inset tool, apply the value of 50 cm and make sure the group inset mode is set. Now, select the remaining polygons. After we are done, inset selected polygons, but this time use the bi-polygon mode, so that every single polygon you choose has its own inset. One more inset here. Now, select the inner polygons and delete them with the delete key. Also, delete those two bottom polygons to create door openings.
Change the mode to vertices. Click one on your keyboard.
Select the higher vertices and align them with the floor level.
Go back to the polygon mode and choose the bi-angle option. In 3DS Max's polygon mode, the bi-angle option selects all polygons that have the angle between them equal to or lower than the maximum value. In my case, 45 degrees. Pretty handy. Now delete the top and bottom polygons of the object.
Lastly, we'll make the window and door opening a bit smaller to match the dimensions of the windows and doors. Go to the vertex mode and move the top and bottom vertices by 15 cm in the y-axis.
Select the bottom vertices and move them up by the same amount.
Great! Now let's apply the shell modifier to add some thickness to the walls. Set the inner amount to 45 cm and make sure to select straighten corners to create correct geometry and avoid future problems. Next, we'll model the ceiling, which will also serve as a decorative element to make the elevation more complex. Delete the modifiers, which are placed on top of the box, and change the height to 30 cm.
Here is how it looks so far.
Apply the Edit Poly modifier and extrude selected size faces by 150 cm to create the balconies. Make sure to extrude by local normals. Next, select all the side polygons and extrude them by 30 cm to create a nice visual effect. Adjust the pivot position of the ground floor to make it easier to snap. Then create three instances of the floor. Repeat the process for the ceiling. Now I will show you a cool trick. You can select every other floor and select mirror. It's located at the top of the toolbar. Set the mirror axis to X and check out how awesome our building just got. Do the same for the ceiling elements to create an impression of a flowing elevation. I will
simplify the roof element a bit. Delete the existing modifiers on top of the box and create a new Edit Poly modifier. Go to the front view, select all the side polygons and extrude them by 30 cm, just like before, but without the balconies. Make sure to select by local normals. Lastly, we will create the top floor with the enormous balcony. Go to the top view and create a box. Set the dimensions to 800 cm length, 1500 cm width, and 300 cm height. Remove the segments. We'll create this element using the Boolean modifier. Place the box on top of the building and create the reference box for the openings. Set the dimensions of the reference box to 250 cm length, 250 cm width, and 180 cm height. Align it with the middle of the top floor. You can use Align Selection tool by pressing Alt plus A on the keyboard. Place the reference box in the corner and copy it 3 times. Apply the Boolean modifier to the top floor box and select all the reference boxes with the Merge option on. I will create 2 more reference boxes for the doors. Set the reference box dimensions to 250 cm length, 200 cm width, and 235 cm height. Place boxes at the middle at the top floor and merge them with the top floor geometry. Next, apply the Edit Poly modifier and delete all the unnecessary polygons. Lastly, apply the Shell modifier with the same values as before. Let's create one more element for the roof. Make it a bit bigger than the top floor, 830 by 1530 by 10 cm will work just fine. Alright, time for some final touches. Let's add the chamfer modifier. Remember, if the objects are created as instances, the modifier will apply to all of them. You just need to create one. See? It's already there. We'll need to copy the chamfer modifier and paste it on top of the top elements as they were created as separate objects. And the architecture is done.
I'll unhide all the windows and the doors so you can see the final result. In this tutorial, we won't go through modeling these parts, but you can use ready models or model them by yourself using similar modeling methods. If you want to know how to model the windows step by step, we have a lesson that covers it well in the visualization course.
Looks so much better. We need to adjust one thing though. The bottom part of the windows are intersecting with the building. Let's go to the Edit Poly modifier and adjust the height of the opening vertices. Like I said before, since they're all instances, you only have to do this once. Isn't it great? Perfect.
In this case, we're modeling the buildings that are in the background of the scene, so we'll create a low poly balustrade.
Create a line in the top view.
Make sure to enable 2.5 snapping. In this case, we can snap to any object in 3D space, but the object stays at the same level it was before. Here, all the vertices will be on the level 0.
Place the created shape on top of the balcony and apply the extrude modifier. The balustrades are usually 110 cm high. Next, apply the Edit Poly modifier to create glass panels. Go into the edge mode and create 2 connections at the front of the balustrade. Now, Add corner edges to the selection and through the chamfer option to create empty spaces between the polygons. Set the chamfer value to 0.5 cm, remove this segment, and select the open option. The chamfers we just created spaces between the sheets of glass. Add some thickness to the glass by applying the shell modifier and copy the object to create a ray. Let's delete all modifiers which are placed on top of the line and turn the Enable in Renderer and Enable in Viewport on. Change the mode to Rectangular and adjust the dimensions to your needs. Lastly, let's align the rail with the glass by moving the vertices. And that's it! We don't need a chamfer modifier since the goal was to create a low poly geometry, but you can apply it if you want.
If you want to learn more about creating visualizations from start to finish using 3ds Max with Corona and V-Ray, join our course. You can also stay here on YouTube and watch more videos. Bye bye!